Hey everyone, Piano Man Chuck here, and I have with me today the Casio Privia PX350 and the Kurzweil Artis SE. Why am I comparing these two? Well, it's a long story, but to make a long story short, my Privia PX5S is in lockdown for rehearsal with a classic rock band that I'm in. And basically, I've been trying different keyboards with this band when we gig out or when we rehearse. And I've tried it with the Kurzweil Forte, which was excellent. Excellent. I mean, that was top of the line board for me. But due to its weight and size, I just couldn't deal with that. So that board is gone. I've done it with the PX5S, which is the same key bed as the PX350. So pretty much the same functionality as far as your basic bread and butter sounds, but the PX5S has a lot more that you could do. I didn't need that extra stuff, so I used a PX350 on the gigs because it has a music rest where I can put my music on, my notes rather, what parts I play, where I come in, that kind of thing. I don't have that on the PX5S. I have to bring a music stand, which kind of defeats the portability factor of the PX5S, because now I'm carrying two things when I can just do one thing here. And the Kurzweil Artis SE also has an optional music stand that you can buy. And even Kawai offers an optional music. Well, actually, their products include a music stand. So as far as gigging goes, the Privia PX350 is so lightweight. It's 24 pounds. It's got a music stand. It's got general MIDI. This is perfect for me. The Artis SE, also a great gigging board. But why it doesn't work for me? It doesn't have the general MIDI sound set. It does not support general MIDI at all. And the reason that's important to me, because some of the songs that we do, like, I don't know, I'm Your Captain from Grand Funk Railroad, it requires sea shore sounds, ocean waves, that kind of thing. General MIDI has a sound for that. If I'm doing something like Daydream Believer and an alarm clock goes on, the telephone sound works perfectly for that alarm clock when you play it up higher. And again, because of the lack of general MIDI, that Artis doesn't do it for me. Everything else, the sound quality is really superb on the Artis SE as opposed to the Privia. But when it comes to piano, that's debatable. The piano, some people like the Privia better, some people like the Artis SE better. But the main thing was we were doing this song from Cream called Badge. I don't know if you remember that. Anyway, the piano part goes something like this. No problem. You come over to the Artis to do the same thing. So you heard it right there. You don't hear the clear notes, so this is better with that. You hear every single note. All right, now, here's the thing. That's kind of weird, because if I play the same note on a white key repetitiously, using these two fingers, I'm not hearing every single time I'm pressing on that note. Whereas I am on the Artis SE. So it's kind of, I'm kind of at a loss because. That time it did it, but it doesn't always do it. So it's inconsistent. So no matter which key bed that you use, there's going to be some inconsistencies. So I thought I'd share that with you. And, you know, it's really fascinating. But anyway, in another video, because now I'm a keyboardist for a classic rock band rather than just a solo pianist, I'm going to go into some detail about the different keyboards that I used on these gigs, why I liked them, why I didn't like them, why I used them, why I don't want to use them. In the meanwhile, Piano Man Chuck, peace out. Thanks for watching.